Not to cause any more delays, may I proceed the presentation. Today I was assigned to share with you the scholarship opportunities from PR China to Southeast Asian students in 2017. May I also book this opportunity for to ask Dr. Kapot, the director of EMS, to convey some message to all the audience and participants, please. Dr. Kapot.
Good afternoon to all of you. This film of this information, we try to share with you what we got from the Public Republic of China, and this is an opportunity, a scholarship opportunity for Southeast Asia students for this year. The scholarships not only for the bachelor but also for the master and also for the doctor degree. So please distribute to all your colleagues, your friends, or your son, your daughter, or your other activity or other you nephew or something like this. Give all the information to them, and then let them see and practice to get the connection with every university that Pasama will tell you. We hope that we can send more than 1,000 students to China from Southeast Asia this year, and then I need your help to distribute all the information to all the students who want to join to the China University, or the teacher or the lecturer who want to get a master or PhD program in China. So please distribute this information and proactive to our system to get the information. So I'd like Atama to explain more detail for this program. So Atama, it's time is yours.
Thank you very much, sir. For this academic year 2017, we received from three scholarship provider at least to disseminate this scholarship program to Southeast Asia. The first scholarship will be close the application at the end of next month in April, 30th April. It's Sun Yat-sen University scholarship in Guangzhou province, in Guangzhou, Guangdong province. There will be 200 outstanding undergraduate students to be selected to receive the scholarship for bachelor degree. The second scholarship is Jasmine Jensu scholarship for Southeast Asian students. They expected to have 11 excellent students to receive the scholarship from the Jiangsu province in China. And the deadline of its second scholarship is 31st May 2017. And another scholarship that provides for Southeast Asian students this year is Guizhou Government Scholarship. They provide 1,028 scholarships for a doctoral degree, master degree, bachelor degree, vocational and general scholar. This scholarship deadline is 30th June 2017. They have different provisions and different criteria, also different application procedure, which I would like to share with you in the next slide. For students and scholarship, the language of instruction will be only Chinese language, but they also open for the students who cannot speak Chinese at all to study in Chinese language for 1 year. And they have to pass the test for the continuation of pursue their studies in bachelor degree in the next 4 years. For the application procedure, before the application can be successfully completed, the students need the recommendation letter from recommending unit that listed in the more details in the website that I will inform you later. The second scholarship is Jasmine Jiangsu Scholarship for Southeast Asia. This scholarship provides higher vocational level and bachelor level scholarships. It can, there are 44 full scholarships and 43 partial scholarships. The language of instruction in Jiangsu province for the scholarship can be either Chinese language or English language. Because they provide hundreds of English language courses in Jiangsu province. The application has to be sent through email to the scholarship office in Jiangsu province, and details of the provision will be informed during the admission. The next scholarship that provides for Southeast Asian students this year is the Guizhou Government Scholarship. They provide in several levels of education, since general scholar, Chinese language, as a visiting scholar, vocational, bachelor, master, and doctoral. And the language of instruction will be in Chinese, but they can provide a few in English language. The provision of the scholarship is either full scholarship or partial scholarship, but the students have to email directly to the each university, and the provision can be discussed during the application. This is the list of participating institutes in Jiangsu province to the Jasmine Jiangsu Scholarship. There are 30 institutes get approval this year for the Jasmine Scholarship, namely Suzhou University, Nanjing University, Southeast University, Nanjing Normal University, Jiangsu University, Nanjing University of Science and Technology, Nanjing University of Aeronautics and Astronautics, Yangzhou University, Nanjing University of Information Science and Technology, Nanjing Medical University, Hohai University, Nanjing Agricultural University, Nantong University, Xi'an Xiaotong, Liverpool University. This is a private university, so the tuition fees are higher than the others. Nanjing University of Post and Telecommunications, Nanjing Technology University, Jiangsu University of Science and Technology, Jiangsu Normal University, Jiangsu University, Jiangsu Institute of Technology, Global Institute of Software Technology. This is also a private institute, so the tuition fee will be higher. Nanjing Polytechnic Institute, Jiangsu Institute of Commerce, Jiangsu College of Information Technology, Wuxi Institute of Technology, Wuxi Vocational Institute of Commerce, Nanjing Institute of Industry Technology, Yangzhou Polytechnic Institute, Nantong College of Science and Technology, Jiangsu Animal Husbandry Vocational College. For more information of this individual institute, the students can access via website http://www.studyinjiangsu.org, listed at the end of this presentation. This is also the list of 18 participating institutes in Guizhou province. As you can see in the list, there are names of the institutions in the first column and the scholarship categories in the last column on the right. The participating universities are Guizhou University, Guizhou Normal University, Guizhou Mingzi University, Guizhou University of Finance and Economics, Guizhou Medical University, Sun Yi Medical University, Guizhou Institute of Technology, Guizhou Vocational Technology Institute, Guiyang University, Guizhou University of Engineering Science, Sun Yi Normal College, Zhongren University, Kaili University, Guiyang Physical Education College, Guizhou Jiaodong College, Guiyang Nursing Vocational College, Guiyang Vocational and Technology College, and Zhongren Polytechnic College. For more information, the students can access in the website listed at the end of this page. Apart from this scholarship, as we just come back from China in the last 2 weeks,
We also received the offer to provide scholarship from Hainan province. They provide also in doctor, master, bachelor degree and certificate, but more details will be informed later. The second scholarship that we learned from the visit in China in the last 2 weeks is the China government scholarship, which will be provided to others, so many universities in China. But one university that we visit is the China University of Mining Technology, which also one of the best university provide programs in mining and other engineering development. And also from Zhejiang Fashion Institute of Technology in Ningbo, Zhejiang province, which will be informed, which will provide more information and details of scholarship later on. This is the tentative timeline for a test organized by Asimio Center, which will be confirmed and informed later. For the students who would like to have the recommendation letters from the CMEO unit, the center will provide a test in April, the 8th and the 22nd, and also for in May, during May, on the 13th or the 27th, and also during in June, in the on the 3rd and 10th of June. This is only the tentative timeline, and for the students who would like to register, can register, can have pre-registration, and we will send more information about the test or the recommending letter system to each student to register later. And we also received some video, very interesting video about two of the scholarships that we present today, which is Sun Yat-sen University and study in Jiangsu, and we would like to share with you. This is the introduction to Sun Yat-sen University. the video is quite long because it takes about 20 minutes. So according to the suggestion of our director, we will share with you the video in our Vimeo website later on. So the interesting student can access this video in the Vimeo website later on. And for more details of this scholarship as well as video, which will be uploaded later on, you can access in the link presented in the PowerPoint here. And for the students who would like to have the recommendation letter, you can pre-register at the following website. And for more information, you can also email one of these officers who will be able to answer your questions and also convey your concerns or provide more information about the scholarship later on. Thank you very much for your time today. And we will upload this video in the website for your assistant to disseminate the information of this scholarship to your institute and your network. And thank you very much for your kind attention and cooperation in the future.